Ahoy, this is Christopher Maelstrom. This is Metal Ignition.
Kick the interview off, Chris. Thanks for joining us. Thanks to everyone out there tuning in to Metal Ignition. We've got Chris Bowers, the lead man and the captain of the ship of Alestorm on the line here today.
Ahoy.
And Chris, look, thanks for joining us. I just wanted to, you know, obviously catch up, talk about what's going on in the land of Alestorm. We've got the fourth album coming out very soon. Sunset on the Golden Age, and that's due out on the 1st of August for us Australians here, and every few days after that for pretty much the rest of the globe. So must be pretty excited about all that, Chris.
Yeah, I'm very, very excited. It's been like over 3 years since we released a... God, it has been over 3 years since we released an album. That's insane.
Yep.
Wow. Wow, that's big. I'm just looking forward to going, hey everybody, it's us again, remember me, we're Alestorm.
All the fans are eagerly anticipating the release.
Yeah, I just hope no one's too disappointed in it. I think it's good. Everyone I've talked to says they reckon it's probably our best, so I'm like, oh my god, this is going to be good.
Yeah.
So I'm just looking forward to getting reactions to it.
So what do you truly believe makes the album stand out? What do you consider?
I think we just, to be honest, got better at writing songs. It's as simple as that, to be honest. It's everything's a lot more focused, you know. I mean, in the past we've kind of thrown riffs together and said that'll do, but this time around it's, you know, everything's been really focused on songwriting. You're getting some really, you know, little catchy little tunes going down, you know.
Yep.
Nice few heavy riffs and melodies linking it all together, and I think it's just, and also better performance. You know, we're getting better musicians. You know, we're still young. You know, we're all a bunch of kids writing crappy music. So, you know, most of us couldn't play our instruments when we started this band. So we're getting better. We know how to work better in a studio now. So it's just simply a much more polished performance, and the songs are awesome, and it's just really good.
Do you think it's got something to do with all the band members sticking around, because you've had a lot of lineup changes over the years of people coming and going and switching instruments, and you think you guys are all just sort of finally gelled and now you're like, right, this is what we want to do? Because obviously, you know, Alestorm, you know, it started out, you know, many, well, what was it, 2008 was the, is that the first release?
Yeah.
2008. Captain Morgan's Revenge, like that was pretty much when Alestorm was Alestorm, when you guys first brought that sound. You changed the name to Alestorm, and like, did you ever question the longevity of the band, like when you started off going with the type of sound you guys were going for back then, and still true to this day as well with the new record? You're not forgetting any of that, but were you afraid listeners would hear a song, crack a smile, maybe have a bit of a laugh and never not come back for more?
Yeah, I mean completely. When we started this band, we had, you know, zero expectations of anything. You know, we were like, you know, we wanted to play a couple of gigs in a pub in our hometown, and that would have done us, to be honest. And then suddenly this record deal appears, and we made that first album, Captain Morgan's Revenge. And I was like, sweet, I get to release an album on a proper record label. That's me happy, you know. That's all I ever wanted to do, was, you know, that was my new goal, was just simply, I've got an album out, that's great. Now suddenly it's like, oh, we can make a career out of this. People like it. I mean, I had no idea it was going to be this popular. And so, you know, we're just kind of winging it the whole way, just, you know, seeing what we can get away with for as long as we can.
Yeah.
So it's all very ridiculous. I still don't quite understand why it's happened, but it has happened. So I'm happy.
I do have to ask you, Chris. Is everyone in the band as fond of pirates as they need to be? To continue playing that type of music?
I wouldn't say we're particularly keen on pirates. You know? I don't know much about historical piracy. It's just something fun to sing about. I mean, saying yo-ho-ho is nice, that's all. I mean, none of us are really into pirates. It's just we just like making music. It just happens to be about pirates.
So okay. That's cool. All right. Yeah, interesting.
Like, everything I know about piracy, I learned from Johnny Depp and Wikipedia. So,
Pirates of the Caribbean.
It's mostly about the party and stuff, and you being stupid and writing silly songs about goofy shit. That's what I like the most. Yeah, it's just been also been the fact that we play this completely, let's call it bonkers kind of music. It's, you know, you wouldn't think, oh yeah, a bunch of guys with guitars playing accordion noises is going to be a really successful metal band. You know, you don't really, it's not the kind of thing you'd associate with popularity. So, you know, it's, you couldn't be in this and expecting it to be big. You just do it because it's funny.
Yeah. It's funny you should mention that, because I noticed that there's definitely several songs on the record to which most people's would be quite surprised have some really heavy key monumental parts with screaming and riffs that, like, I could picture people throwing down to.
Yeah, it's, I mean, we kind of realised that, you know, we don't have to pretend we're a folk metal band or a power metal band. We can just do whatever the hell we want. And, you know, while the core of Ailstorm is always writing these kind of stupid party folk metal songs, it's, you know, we're not idiots. We know what metal is. We know how to make, you know, some serious, crushing, ridiculous, symphonic, epic stuff. I mean, like, the music I listen to is, you know, most of the band listens to. We listen to very kind of technical, epic, extreme stuff, you know. So it's, we know what, how to make something ridiculous and crushing and over the top. So we kind of stick that in now and then, just to kind of throw people off the scent. They think, yeah, oh, here's a bunch of, you know, douchebags making stupid pop metal, then suddenly, you know, extreme metal symphonic overload. It's like, what is going on here? It's fun just to throw in all these random elements from time to time, definitely.
That's it to a T as well. You said it perfectly. Like, that's exactly what I thought when I heard the shift to that heavy throwdown screaming riff in Magnetic North, and I was just like, whoa, like, you sit back and it's just, it's incredible. And then I think like epicness is in the 1741, the Battle of
Cartagena, I think. It's kind of a, it's quite unpronounceable unless you're Spanish.
Oh, I stand no chance then. I'm pronouncing that
Cartagena. I don't know if you're foreign, who cares. I just said, like,
but there's a really great solo in that song.
And yeah, that solo actually took 300 takes to record. 300. Not joking, that took so long recording. Wow. That. You cannot imagine. We were there for like hours recording that riff. And I think Danny wanted to kill himself by the end of it. But
what's down the line for you guys? You got a lot of shows coming up almost every single day for a solid 2 months, isn't it?
Yeah, we go on tour. We start on September the 12th. We've got this tour of mainland Europe, supported by Brainstorm and the band from Wollongong, Trolltagen. They're coming out with us. Then after the Europe thing is done, we're going to the UK. We're doing this tour of just all pirate bands. So it's us and direct supporters from the band from Brisbane, Lagerstein. We just love touring with Aussie bands for some reason. You guys are all fun and stuff. So so that's basically what we're gonna do. We can have, like, yeah, 45 shows back to back, and I'm just worried I might die. It's a genuine concern of mine.
I'm gonna have to hold back a bit. What's the drink of the day at the moment?
Strawberry daiquiris. I love strawberry daiquiris. I just love cocktails. You know, it's summer up here, so you know, sit out on the terrace, get a cocktail. That's what I want.
You migrated to those from that cruise you went on. Seven thousand ton of Graham.
Yeah, I just love cocktails. I think every drink should be in a silly glass and maybe on fire. Yeah.
Sounds good to me. Is there any plans for a video? They haven't dropped. You haven't dropped a video at all yet.
Oh, we did a video for the song "Drink."
Yes, of course. Yeah.
That was a lot of fun. We went to Germany and got drunk and got some babes to take off their clothes, and it was like, you know, that was kind of cool. We enjoyed every second of that. But I think we're gonna do some sort of you know these lyric videos people do these days.
Sure.
I think there's one of those coming out for Hangover sometime this week.
Oh, so that's
gonna be fun, because a lot of people are gonna be pretty pissed off with that song, because it's, you know, it's complete sellout pop metal. I mean, there's rapping in it and everything. It's just ridiculous.
And, it is a really great cover. I will say that, Chris. And I have listened to the original a fair bit. My 4-year-old daughter quite enjoys that song. as odd as it is, I think it's just that bounce in the song, I suppose. You know, she likes dancing, so she enjoys it. So I've heard enough of that song. And then when I pull up your album and I see, instantly my eyes went to it. And I'm like, is that song called Hangover? Like, that sounds cool. Like, that sounds like a song title, you know, Al Storm would come up with. Let's go with that. And then it turned into be a cover of that song. And I was just like, oh, wow. And I was just like, oh, wow. Like, this is it. This is actually really great. So...
The whole, I just love that whole, you know, the second verse, the whole rapping section with like accordions going on. It's like, what the hell is going on here? It's just complete nonsense. And yeah, I just can't wait to see how the general metal public is going to react to that one.
Very well. There's a few different covers songs coming out at the moment, actually. So I don't think generally people give a fuck, to be honest, at the moment.
Yeah, well, you know, most cover songs don't tend to have rapping in them, though. It's especially not folk metal covers. So we'll see.
So we're gonna see you guys come play in Australia once towards the end of the year. Maybe Soundwave is on the cards for you guys.
Well, the thing about Soundwave is, you know, it's been offered to us before. It's been suggested to us before as well. But it's like, I'm not sure if I want to do Soundwave. I mean, sure, it's exposure, blah, 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 but, you know, we'd end up being one of these bands that plays on the 7th stage at 11 a.m. for 20 minutes. It's like, I don't want that. I want to come to Australia, and I want to play for, like, you know, an hour and a half to, like, 1,000 of our fans, you know, and have a great time, you know. I think I always prefer that a lot more to just, you know, doing a little tiny festival slot that no one cares about. So I'm not sure if we're going to do Soundwave ever. I mean, unless, you know, maybe in 10 years' time we're the biggest band in the world and we can headline it, that'd be great. But until that day comes, I don't think it's right for us. I mean, I'm sure I'll eat these words one day, but who knows?